Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Hilly, Catherine, how are you? Hotness. So last week we spoke about the pressure to get married, and now, okay, today I want to talk about pressure to have kids. Let's imagine you finally put into pressure. I finally got married, and then everyone's like, okay, so she's going to have kids soon, he's going to have kids soon. And then 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, no child. It becomes a problem. Like the whole community starts carrying rumors. Some start saying, okay, it's either she's had so many abortions in the past, that's why she's not having a child. And then the rumor goes around and you start thinking, you get depressed. But please do not listen to people. So number one, they start with the whole rumor of abortion, saying you've let a lot of babies go in the past, even when they don't even know your past. And then when that doesn't work, or they find out, oh, it's not true, and they move on to the fact that, I said it, this girl has a spiritual husband somewhere that is not going to let her go. She got married, but now he's not going to let her have kids. And this brings about another trouble. Like, you do one thing or the other. This is the part where you get very, very prayerful, but you need to also have been a good Christian right from the start, right? You know what I'm saying? Yeah, we all know that a child brings happiness. And when you don't have a child, people start saying, oh, she's a barren woman. And it gets to a point where some people can't actually go out. When people are going out with their kids, they can't go to those places because some people are petty. When they see you talk to their kids, they're like, no, don't go near her. She doesn't have a child. No, she can't give birth. And that thing really hurts. Like, we need to start thinking about other people's feelings. I know you don't give a hoot about other people, but once in a while, you need to think about them because things like this actually lead to depression for a couple of people and could also lead to suicide. So when you pressure people into doing things, you should think about their feelings and try to talk to them in a very polite way and manner. Also, let's talk about the fact that when a newly married couple is yet to have a child, the next thing people start saying is, oh, it's the woman. It's the sins of her past. Maybe she has done some things in the past that's not letting her have a child. But it is the couple's problem. If they do not have a child, they would find a way to have kids. It's either they go seek medical care or they do what they want to do. And if it doesn't work medically, that's why there are actually treatments like IVF, that's in vitro fertilization. They can have a child. If they can't, then they can get surrogates. These are solutions. So when things like this come up, don't just put all the problems on people. Try to find solutions for them, and you can suggest these things instead of just shouting, oh, she's a barren woman, she can't have a child. No, don't do that. If none of this works and they can't have a child of their own, then they can go for adoption. So many kids are put up for adoption, and you know, there's this Yoruba saying, Ori Omoni Gbomo Waye. Maybe when you bring a child home, you adopt a child, you might end up having your child. Like, I've seen so many movies where this thing happens. So please do not pressure anyone into marriage or to have kids. It's not easy, trust me. Finally, let me just talk about the fact that here the Lord give it, but you also need to put in work. You need to know what you want to do and plan with your partner. And yeah, those who have been pressured in the past about having kids once they get married should actually not feel bad. There are so many other alternatives. And don't let people's pressure push you down. This is why, like I said last week, you need to marry someone who's understanding, someone who you can communicate with, because then both of you can come together to find solutions to this. And voila, the problem is solved. So if you love your partner, and you guys communicate well and understand one another, I'm sure all of this will be resolved. I'm just saying all this not as a professional, but from my point of view. And yes, I'm not married. I'm sure many of you are like, oh, she's not married to the single lady, what does she know? I'm just saying from what I've known, from experience, from what I've seen happening to people around me. So basically, yes, that is that. But if you've had first-hand experience on being pressured to have kids, and all of this, just let me know in the comment section below, which is the box below. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Thank you so much for watching this video. It's your lady, Catherine, a real hotness. And don't forget to click the subscribe button. Subscribe, subscribe, subscribe. Bye, guys. See you next week.